On the early morning hours of April 30th, 2023, a moderate magnitude 4.5 earthquake was felt throughout the Imperial Valley in California, having been centered on the southeastern edge of the Salton Sea. However, this earthquake was centered 1.25 miles east of a local active volcano which few people know exists. The complex I'm referring to is the Salton Buttes volcano. Having completely formed in the last 10,000 years, this small-scale volcano contains magma which actively exists at depth, probably around 3 miles depth in my opinion, although we do not know the exact depth of the present magma. This molten rock actively vents gases onto the surface, forming dozens of active fumaroles and mud pots. This magma even powers a local geothermal power plant, generating enough electricity for several hundred thousand homes. But, back to the earthquake which occurred, it was followed by 28 earthquakes in the next 5 hours, representing a true earthquake swarm. This cluster consisted of 15 earthquakes large enough to be potentially felt, with 9 magnitude 2s, 3 magnitude 3s, and 3 magnitude 4 quakes. Since these were clustered in close proximity to 4 of this volcano's 5 vents, you might think that they are volcanic in origin. However, fear not, as these quakes were luckily not magmatic, although they probably were volcanic-related. The Salton Buttes volcano is located in far southern California on the southeastern edge of the Salton Sea, where it is 15.8 miles north-northwest of the city of Raleigh. The Salton Buttes are the only land-based volcano in the United States to be completely below sea level. As a whole, this complex could be best described as a lava dome complex consisting of 5 rhyolite lava domes which erupted in explosive eruptions between 5800 BCE and 200 CE. These vents are generally quite small, with lava not traveling any further than a half mile. The placement of these 5 vents in the shoreline is most likely sheer coincidence, as they are parallel with a series of hidden faults in the Salton Sea itself. The reason for the existence of this complex is that the Salton Sea is a small-scale rift zone of sorts. To the north is the major San Andreas Fault, and to the south is the Imperial Fault. In between these two faults, the crust is spreading apart to the southeast and northwest, allowing for magma to intrude into the crust via a path of least resistance and occasionally erupt onto the surface. While all of these 5 vents used to be distinct islands, the level of the Salton Sea has drastically decreased over the last several decades due to a combination of less regional precipitation and water overuse. This declining water level has caused previously hidden geothermal features such as mud pots and fumaroles to appear on land. Due to the lake water and combination of groundwater, hydrothermal fluids in the ground are heated when they encounter rock overlying an active magma chamber. This rock heats the water, which carries volcanic gases along with it, causing it to be pushed upwards and reach the surface, but sometimes along the way encountering a fault line, causing it to rupture and generate an earthquake. The earthquake which occurred on April 30th was merely 2 orders of magnitude larger than what is typical, with the aftershocks not representing additional hydrothermal activity, but rather stress release due to the aftershock itself. This fact is best displayed via when the recorded aftershocks occurred in terms of the number of minutes after the main shock, which closely follows the expected 1 over X rate of aftershocks. In other words, for each minute after a main shock earthquake, the chance of an aftershock decreases, being around 1 over x, with x representing the number of minutes which have passed. As a whole, this earthquake sequence is likely to continue at a far weaker rate for the next 1 to 2 days, and then will likely cease altogether. This earthquake swarm was the strongest earthquake swarm to occur in 22 months at the Salton Buttes, but earthquake swarms are quite common there due to its hydrothermal system. Past stronger earthquake swarms with up to a magnitude 5.3 main quake have not resulted in a volcanic eruption, and the same will almost certainly be the case with the current situation, meaning a volcanic eruption is not about to occur. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.